Gather around me, hearties. You know, old Davy gets a bit dry from time to time. For a tankard of your finest ale, I'll tell you a tale that'll curdle your blood, straighten your hair, and get you to swear off punching yourself. And now, me bully boys, the tale of the ghost ship, the French Mistake.
I've heard that one.
How about the tale of Bloody Bob and the treasure of San Marcos?
I heard that one too.
Well then, me laddies, you're gonna love the tale of Boxer Manny McGregor and the Amazon Warriors.
That's the one about the island of the crazed nymphomaniacs?
Arr, matey, the very same.
Heard it.
Did I tell you my mom's in an iron lung and my little sister needs braces?
Thirsting for a good tale? Then look no further than Ahoy! The movie.
I'm here. I made it to the moon. It took me a while, but it was worth it, because I love the moon. I love the way my stomach rubs up against it. Ooh, and the best part of all is that it's mine. It's all mine. Hey, wait a minute. This stuff isn't chocolate. It's dirt. Lousy, stinking dirt. It was Fred. Fred told me the moon was made out of chocolate. He lied to me, and now I've got no choice. I must return to Earth and destroy him. I'm coming for you, Fred. Say your prayers, because I'm a-coming. A 100 bottles of dirt on the wall, 100 bottles of dirt, yeah! Take one down, pass it around. 99 bottles of dirt on the wall, 50 bottles of dirt on the wall, 50 bottles of dirt, yeah! Take one down, pass it around. 40 pass it around, take two bottles of, one bottle of dirt. It's Fred! He sabotaged the ship! If I can just hold my breath! Computer, let's start out by scanning for Fred. Locate his ship and set a course to intercept and, Whoa! Look at that! I can see myself in the glass! Cool, Daddy-O. Hey, there he is. There's Fred. Why, you lousy, stinking Sputnik scum! Poop! Hey! You lied to me, Fred. You told me that the moon was made out of chocolate.
Whoa, hold on just a minute. I did not say the moon was made out of chocolate. Now, as I recall, what I did say is that the planet Mars is covered with jelly beans.
Jelly beans? What kind of jelly beans?
Idiot! We are talking about the red planet, are we not? So you would expect maybe to have mostly the red ones. You know, like strawberry and watermelon.
Yeah, but what about the blue ones? Aren't there any blue jelly beans?
Oh, yeah, sure there are. That's what the oceans are filled with. But you've got to hurry, because once the word gets out, then the candy companies will move in. The capitalist pigs will fence off the entire planet. Oh, they'll have some sort of excuse, like national security, a deadly virus or something like that. But you can bet your life that they'll be living like fat American cats on the jelly bean planet. Hey! Don't forget to brush your teeth! Stupid worm.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. I warned that kid 100 times to not go near my daughter. If you touch my little girl again, you'll wish that you were dead. I'll wrap your stupid little pail around your filthy head. Listen to your mother, Jill. I know, I've been around. You don't want a man who carries a bucket and drinks from a hole in the ground. Thank you.
Down.
Up.
Down.
Up.
Down.
Up.
Down.
Up.
Down.
The sun has not yet risen, but there's work to do. My wife is sick and cannot get out of bed. Where is the feed for the chickens? I do not know. It is not where I left it yesterday. I don't want to work today. I want to drive to town and drink a margarita instead. That's all.
Look at me. Hey, dude. Dude. Hey, dude.
This one is for the little lady in the back. It's in the way you walk. It's in the way you talk, baby. Why hide it? You dig my stuff. It's in the way you cook. It's in the way you clean, baby. Why fight it? You dig my stuff. You can keep pretending, but I see you over there digging me, baby. Just digging my stuff. Yeah.
Thank you. Hello. There is an old king named Francis, who, when going somewhere, always prances. He rules wickedly, and we live in fear, but on weekends we always have dances. Thank you.
Yeah.
T'es la gâchette la plus rapide de l'Ouest. Ben, y'a comme un problème. Parce que la plus fine gâchette, c'est moi. Alors à midi pile, je t'attendrai dehors. Et on verra bien qui sera le plus rapide.
Pas du feu.
Ha ha ha.
This peaceful valley is the home of the Squeezle, a graceful woodland creature that is part flying squirrel and part weasel. Squeezles are always hungry, so foraging for nuts and competing for territory keeps them quite busy. But their world is about to change. Something is coming. Something big. Yes, it's the return of the great shuddering nut! It's time for action! Adventure! Bravery! This is your goal to glory! Long ago, the flaming nut first came to the land, and the Squeezles were drawn to it. Brave Squeezle Jeff approached with a peace offering, and he was swallowed whole. The Squeezles were very afraid. But then Jeff emerged with treasures that defy description. And the message from the great, shuddering nut. The Squeezles must go forth and find all the shiny rocks, then bring them to the nut when it returns. They will be rewarded with amazing treasures. Hey, Sparky, go get some gold. And don't forget, hold on to your nuts! Welcome, my friend. What? Where is the gold? You bring me nothing, idiot! You must cough up some gold or I crush you like bug. Holy mackerel. Yes, yes, this is adequate for now. Okie dokie. Who wants many treasures? Ah, yes. Classic beauty of Swanson. Look, rocket fuel. Very powerful. Ooh, very big magic. Use it wisely. That's a good one. Huh? Oh, la la. Now this I like. Now, I have deal for you. Go find many glass rock. I come back, give you whole jar of time. Deal, yes? Okay, bye-bye, Sparky.